This pair programming, it's really an interesting thing. You have one student that's the driver, you have the other student that's the navigator. So one person is telling the other person what to do and where to click.
Pair programming is really important in my classroom because it allows kids to work together. But it's also important and critical when introducing pair programming to talk about the difference between helping someone do something and then doing it for them.
I strategically set up, okay, this student knows a lot of the coding concepts. I'm going to have them start as the driver. And the person who maybe needs a little bit more support, they're the navigator, who are asking questions. They're trying to figure out how it works, but they're working with someone who they feel comfortable with to make it successful.
I think some advice for making pair programming work in your classroom, especially if it's the first time, is first of all, feel free in selecting the pairs initially. Students that you know will generally work well together, and take that, and I think that will go a long way. And then secondly, feel free to shorten those segments of pair programming, especially as students build endurance in pair programming.
Let them realize that this pair is going to be so helpful for later on when they're debugging, when they're writing code and they can't get it to work exactly right, because two heads are always better than one.